Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss the following question, which says that evaluate the following. First, cosec inverse of cosec of 5 pi by 6. Second, cot inverse of cot of 5 pi by 4. Third, sin of sec inverse of x. Fourth, cos of tan inverse of 2 by 3. Let's start the solution. We have cosec inverse of cosec of 5 pi by 6. We know that cosec inverse of cosec theta is equal to theta for all theta lying in the closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. But here 5 pi by 6 does not lie between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2. So we write 5 pi by 6 as pi minus pi by 6. Therefore, the given expression becomes cosec inverse of cosec of pi minus pi by 6, which is equal to cosec inverse of cosec of pi by 6 as cosec inverse of cosec theta will be equal to theta for all theta belonging to the closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, where theta cannot be equal to 0. Cosec inverse of cosec of theta is equal to theta. Therefore, cosec inverse of cosec of pi by 6 is equal to pi by 6. Therefore, the value of the expression cosec inverse of cosec of 5 pi by 6 is equal to pi by 6, which is the required answer. Now, we'll find the value of the expression cot inverse of cot of 5 pi by 4. We know that cot inverse of cot theta is equal to theta for all theta lying in the open interval 0 to pi, but 5 pi by 4 does not lie between 0 and pi. So we write 5 pi by 4 as pi plus pi by 4. Therefore, the expression cot inverse of cot of 5 pi by 4 becomes cot inverse of cot of pi plus pi by 4, and we know that cot of pi plus theta is equal to cot of theta, so we can write it as cot inverse of cot of pi by 4, which is equal to pi by 4. Therefore, the value of the expression cot inverse of cot of 5 pi by 4 is equal to pi by 4, which is the required answer. Next, we shall find the value of the expression sin of sec inverse of x. Let sec inverse of x be theta, which implies that sec of theta is equal to x In a triangle ABC, if theta is the angle between the lines AC and CB, we know that sec of theta is equal to hypotenuse by base, that is AC upon BC, which will be equal to x by 1. So we have the value of the hypotenuse AC as x and the value of base BC is given by 1. Then we can find the value of the perpendicular AB by using the Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we have perpendicular AB is given by square root of hypotenuse AC square minus base BC square, which is equal to square root of x square minus 1 square, that is square root of x square minus 1. So perpendicular AB is given by square root of x square minus 1, and we know that sine of theta is given by perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is AB upon AC, which will be equal to square root of x square minus 1 by x, which implies that theta is given by sine inverse of square root of x square minus 1 by x. Now we have sec inverse of x as theta, and theta is equal to sine inverse of square root of x square minus 1 by x, which implies that sec inverse of x is equal to sine inverse of square root of x square minus 1 by x. Now substituting the value of sec inverse of x in the given expression, we get sine of sec inverse of x is equal to sine of sine inverse of square root of x square minus 1 by x, which is equal to square root of x square minus 1 by x. Therefore, the value of the expression sine of sec inverse of x is equal to square root of x square minus 1 by x, which is the required answer. Next, we shall find the value of the expression cos of tan inverse of 2 by 3. Let tan inverse of 2 by 3 be 5, which implies that tan of 5 is equal to 2 by 3. In a triangle PQR, if phi is the angle between the lines PR and RQ, and we know that tan of angle phi is given by perpendicular upon base, that is PQ upon RQ, which is equal to 2 by 3. So we have perpendicular PQ as 2 and base RQ as 3. Then we can find the value of the hypotenuse PR by using the Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we have hypotenuse PR is equal to square root of perpendicular PQ square plus base RQ square, that is square root of 2 square plus 3 square, which is equal to square root of 4 plus 9, that is square root of 13. Therefore, hypotenuse PR is equal to square root of 13. Now we know that cos of phi is given by base upon hypotenuse, that is RQ upon RP, which is equal to 3 upon square root of 13, which implies that phi is equal to cos inverse of 3 by square root of 13. Now we have tan inverse of 2 by 3 as phi, and phi is equal to cos inverse of 3 by square root of 13, which implies that tan inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to cos inverse of 3 by square root of 13. Now substituting the value of tan inverse of 2 by 3 in the given expression, we get cos of tan inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to cos of cos inverse of 3 by square root of 13, which is equal to 3 by square root of 13. Therefore, the value of the expression cos of tan inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to 3 by square root of 13, which is the required answer. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.